So episode 24 of Bleach is here, and we are one episode away until we have the 1 hour special next week, which I'm not ready for. I'm never ready for the end of a core because, again, we have to have that long wait afterwards. Hopefully it's longer than 6 months personally, but we're not here to talk about that. We're here to talk about this episode, which I did have a smidgen of a little tiny peek just before hitting the record, and it seems the episode's starting off with a mad flashback. So, some new content, very excited, we're attacking the Soul Palace from the seams of things from what the synopsis gave us from the spoilers, so I'm ready to get into this. So, if you like these live reactions, hit that like, that subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'm interested to get into the lore of Bleach that we never got within the manga. So, let's get into this. I'm excited as fuck. So, yeah, let's go. Right, the black and white flashback, you know. Monk Man. The Soul Society Human World and Heikomundo as the balance of the three realms. The Soul Society. Hey, we got a new baddie! Forming a pact. Entrust the managing of the world of the Shinigami and avert your eyes and enjoy the prosperity of your empire. At this juncture, it would be logical to form an oath, would it not? What a farce. Hey, you are looking young, though. But certainly you don't know anything. At one point, the world was once singular. There would be the Soul King. And who brought the fear of death to the people? There would be the Soul King. I hear the anguish of the souls who have returned to me. The desperate cries of the people who are afraid of death and clinging to that fleet in lives. Sorry, I can't read. I would suggest not using the name so carelessly. Within the three realms, is there peace to be found? Okay, the Almighty. Oh shit, she pulled up! Hey, yo! She pulled up! Hey. Was that Panida? Hey. Pause. No. I gotta go back to that. What? Panida? Surely not. Some more flashback stuff? Okay, we've seen all this. I assume that's Ichibei holding, like, Yuha. It's gotta be, right? That was the Soul King. This dangerous world is held together by us. Deplorable. Okay. He only has two eyes, though. I told you that I could see it, Ichibei. Do you think you could kill me with these hands? My father was nothing more than an escape, and I can only give him life. Oh, wait, Ichibei? Wait, what? Oh, that would make sense, no? Of course that would make sense. You also think I'd give you the Soul King's arm for free? From this point until you die, your eyes will be closed, and will never open again. My father, who has turned to a repulsive lump of flesh being worshipped, I'll give you a new role. Okay. Yo, my brain is going like 10 to the dozen right now. And here we go, we're getting the special guard, or the special forces. The Soldat, and Senjimaru. No Kurinji, but we're getting Senjimaru. Okay. I'm going to pause it there, because I want to talk about that right quick. So as was just said, this was not in the manga and this is completely new. And my interpretation of it, because I don't know if I'll do a review on it or not, but like my interpretation on all of this is like, one, great, because you're already signifying like Yuha to what he wants to do, which is something that was kind of given to us later on down in the manga, like when it was towards ending, and that was Yuha's fear of death. Now I'm wondering if that's actually his fear, or the fears that were implemented to him from the souls that he absorbed over time, if that was the fear of death that, you know, people were having when they were being instilled into him. I wonder if that's the reason why he has this kind of fear, is because of other people's fears that have been latched onto him. But also, the idea of Mimihagi and potentially Panida, I think that was Panida. I definitely think that was Panida being used at that point. It seems that Ichibei also had that arm, which, I mean, it would make sense. If you're going to split up all of the Soul King's limbs, it would only make sense that the right arm man of, like, the Soul King Ichibei would also possess one of those arms. And now I'm wondering how it came to be that Panida kind of detached himself from Ichibei. There's a lot to untangle here, if I'm quite honest with you. So my first impressions are not going to be the best, but it seems that, because I was like, oh, okay, well, I think he sealed Yuha's eyes, or he forcibly closed Yuha's eyes, which would be like the stillness, which would be like Mimihagi, right? Mimihagi is the one that's still, and like Panida's the advanced version of like his arms. So I was like, oh, did he use Mimihagi in that moment? I'm not actually sure. Like, it's a little bit confusing, if I'm honest with you. And I think that that's good, because I think a lot of things are going to be explained much later on throughout the story. And I think it's not supposed to make sense to me quite yet. We're going to have a lot of original content for Core 3. And we might even get a lot more in the next, well, maybe even this episode. We might get a lot this episode, but especially for that 1 hour special, I know that there's quite a few scenes, extra scenes, so maybe we'll have more there. So I'm not going to try and answer this, but it's very interesting that there was a diplomatic approach going forward in this. And it also explains as well that why Yuha didn't use the Almighty when he fought Yamamoto in the war against, you know, the Soul Reapers 1,000 years ago. So I'm glad that this has somewhat nipped that in the bud. I'm glad that it's like drawn that line of like, yes, he had Almighty, but it was completely sealed, and here's why. Without further ado, I'm going to get back into this. There's going to be a lot of discussion about this, and it's very exciting. So anyway, let's get back into this episode. Also, I have to add as well, the baddie, the new Quincy girl with the fucking Reishi gun, with the Reishi AK-47. I love her. I claimed her, boys. I'm sorry. It is what it is. I don't make the rules, right? We just claiming out here like it's some Discord waifu bot. But now, baddie pulled up with the gun. Thought she could do something against Ichibei. Failed, but I appreciate the effort. All right, let's get back into the invasion of the... Okay, we're going straight to the lab... Oh, Bonnie. Hey, Ganju and Bonnie. Look at Bonnie looking great in the 1,000-year Blood War style. What a stupid question. Who do you think launched the Zero Divisions in the first place? Oh, okay. Your sister. Well, okay, there you go. Or your auntie, Ichigo. This is cute. I do like the comedy amongst all this, like, stuff. It's nice to have it every now and then. And everyone's happy. Is that right? It's nostalgic. Very nostalgic. Very exciting, actually. Like, we're going to start seeing normal colours again. Somewhat. And there we go. Like a missile. Yeah. That's cool. And everyone's seen it. The deciding battle, essentially. What an unsightly upward trajectory. Look at the lack of coordination. I love Mayuri. Great. It's funny how that kind of made the whole Soul Society turn into a standstill for a moment. It appears your victory over Gimryu Sai must have gone to your head, or may have gone to your head. Saw that. Royal Palace Swords. Here we go. Come on. Okay. Nice choreography so far. Well, camera movement for sure. Oh, yeah. Light work on the Soldat. Making Soul Reapers look like nothing. Oh, interesting sound effect. Oh. Who did you say was being insolent again? My script is W. What is it? The Wind. Thank you. To the person that in the comment section of my spoilers video said it was The Wind. No, it's The Wind. Okay, so they're not like Wonderwise, where they're absolutely like dumb as fuck. Like, they actually have like a speech. Oh. Ooh. Pop. Pop. Love that. Yeah, I'm not gonna read, like, I'm struggling to read his, like, lisp, you know? See that garb that enrobes your body? Yep. Don't mess with Senjimaru, man. A lowly soldier such as yourself should be honored to be wearing it. Oh, it's giving Nyoin's all, like, I don't know, it gave him something a bit more, you know? Than the manga did. Like, actual, like, facial expressions and whatnot. It's a bad habit I myself can't get rid of. But this is I. You should apologize for not explaining properly. Senjimaru Sutara! That's that girl! For some reason, I thought the Shinigami was going to win. So, what's in the Royal Palace? If you step into the Royal Palace, your target is none other than the Soul King. Soul King. All these worlds were ruled by a godlike being. Were. I heard stories, but I've never met him. And that's big coming from someone that's like a royal clan member. I saw a lot of things when I was training at the royal palace. You know, this kind of brings back memories. At the time we all went to rescue Kuchiki's. Yeah, it was meant for nostalgia. Love that, Kubo. Love that. Except there's no Uryu this time. Yoru Uchinorihime looking bad though, come on. Oh! Uryu's using blue for the first time. Come on. He's not the reason we're going to... Wait. Nah, why is he blushing for Uryu but not for Orihime, who's literally right there? Okay, Nyan's all just falling. Yo, man. They got man falling. Okay. Royal Guard. It's time. Surely, yep. There we go. Asking made the cut. We love that for Asking. Dancer's already been given. X-Axis, Lile Borrow. See? Panida Pancre... Yeah. I forgot how to say his last name. Asking Naklevar. And Gerard Valkyrie. The Miracle. Where is it? There we go. The Miracle. I believe in miracles. A woman's slender arms cannot halt a strike from my blade. Oh, but you're... I mean, okay, maybe he was spitting. He is the Miracle after all. I forgot. Oh, shit. Whose man's is this? They didn't CGI this one. Panida, no! Oh, shit. Panida, wasn't Senjimaru, like, in front of you? Wouldn't it have been, like, you know, more logical to get Senjimaru? Doesn't matter. For the theatrics, I know. Okay. No, no, X-axis, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. Too early to win, too late to know. That was silence. Love that. And there you go. Squad zero in the mud already. Wow. Damn. Headshot though. Okay. Just a bit overkill. I mean, I get why you do it, but it's a bit overkill. Is this all the Zero Division has? Yeah? It's over. Oh, damn. Yo, man. And they were big, too. They were big cities. And man just one-shotted them. Ah, you dickhead. You fought. They ain't gonna go down that easy. This palace is a false royal palace created. Welcome to my... the royal palace. Yeah, the true. It's concealed over there by the monk. Aye, Ichibei. Then the cat out of the bag already. Damn, they really made a fake royal palace. Nah. It's been a while since I made a birth confinement of this scale. It wasn't easy. Yeah, that must have taken like time, man. Even if you penetrate this tree's surface, it will regenerate faster than you can destroy it. Love to see it. But wouldn't you just keep shooting it, right? Like, eventually someone's going to run out of reactor. Or ratio. Hey, okay, here we go. Kurinji. What has your fight been changed to? Let's see. Oh. That's what Mommy Soifon looks like, you know? Ruler of the Grain. Kirio, Hakifune. And where's the goat? Number one! The creator! Yes, sir! And that, everyone, is the sheath of his sword. Let's go. This is about to get silly. It's because I haven't pulled you out in far too long. This blade is feeling a bit unsteady, you see. Oh, Miracle did some damage, though. Hugs from a brother are meant to be evaded. I have to. Ah. Yep. There it is. Ah, this is so cool. Please do Oetsu Namaya justice. The coolest dude in Zero Division. my blade can kill with a single swing. Because it's that sharp. It's an illusion? Fam. I just readied my blade, you see. And you've perfect accuracy. Never missed a bullet that just happened to hit and slice it in two. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Clean. Clean slice. Don't even bother, Panida. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Nice. Yeah, you noticed it. Okay. Is that the point? Because, like, I'm not seeing the actual motion of, like, these slices. So, like, is that the point that they're going for here? Or are they just, like, avoiding doing Sakuga, if that makes sense? I wonder. I mean, it's fine. I would have just liked to have seen, like, the actual motion without a scabbard. So, I can't send it down to the Serete. I'm pretty happy you've come all the way up here to the Royal Palace. Thanks to you, I got my chance to play with her. What's that? The medallion? Is that the medallion with Yuha's, not Yuha, with Yamamoto's Bankai in? Oh yeah, because they can use medallions to teleport, can't they? I'm pretty sure they have a teleportation ability. How many times do I have to tell you not to use my name so carelessly? Clean shot. I'm not sure I won't be able to crush your throat. Okay. And that's how it's going to end. Is there a post-credit scene? Okay, there's no post-credit scene. Okay. Well, it makes sense. It makes sense. Wow, okay, for an episode. Interesting take on what the episode is. Again, I think the rearrangements, interesting, right? Because it's like now we have Kurinji, who essentially had his complete, like, I wouldn't even call it a fight. It was just, like, he was doing things, and, like, it just didn't work. That got removed. We had some great things towards the start in terms of lore, which we already spoke about. And then I think the Zero Division at the moment, which was a big complaint for people back in the day when we were, like, reading the manga on a weekly basis, that I think so far it's been done well. So far. I think the Elite Guard are being shown pretty well, while also keeping the integrity of Squad Zero so far. I think my only quim about all this currently is that, like, it's a really good episode. Like, it's pretty fucking solid. But with Nomaya, with his, you know, the things that he did as, like, a swordsman, like, the absolute, like, mastery that he did with that sword, it's very quick, it's very precise, and it's very instant, I guess the correct way would be saying it. And I'm wondering if that's the point, or they're using it as an excuse to not do, like, those high animation moments. And the reason why I say this is because I just wanted that savagery from the Maya. And while we got it, I was just, I don't know, I expected, like, the thing with Panida, like, this vision in my head of, like, this sword just, like, fucking traveling, like, really fast in, like, first person view, and then just, like, hitting Panida, and then the shot of, like, Nomaya flash stepping on top of his face afterwards. But maybe that's just, like, my vision of it. There's nothing wrong in it. I was just expecting more. But considering that the last two episodes are probably the focus of this entire core altogether, there's still a chance for Nomaya to show up. There absolutely is. Absolute mad chances for, because Nomaya definitely is going to play more of a role next episode for sure. And I did actually tell a lie. I did hear Nomaya actually does get a few extra things, extra scenes or cuts. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna save my opinions for obviously next episodes to really see if Squad Zero really did get the treatment that they deserve. So at the moment, very good. And I said this in the spoiler video too. This is clearly a step up episode for what the next episodes are going to become. This is like a setup through and through. And so far as a setup, great. They removed the whole, like, Ichigo and Orihime thing. You know, he was blushing over Uryu, then over Orihime. But hey, maybe we can get that next episode. Maybe. Copium. The acknowledgement would be nice. But other than that, I think, yeah, like, really, really fucking cool episode. I'm going to be thinking so much about the start of that. So, the flashback and whatnot. And really, like, dig deep and see what everyone else's opinions are on it. Because, like, that's really exciting. I do like that as a Bleach fan to really try and focus on those things. And you notice in my reactions too, when there's new content, like, I will just try and not talk at all, and I'll just like really try and focus. And trust me, you'll see in this edit as well, there's a lot of times where I do actually go back and I try and focus on things, especially with like the whole Pineda thing and or Mimi Hagi with Ichibei's hand and what he had and then what Yuha had. And I, there's a lot. But bring back my Quincy girl with the AK. Bring her back, right? Bring her back. That being said, everyone, I'm going to catch you guys. Also, it was I don't know if you guys noticed, Hubert was also in that flashback as well. So shout outs to Hubert. If you don't know, if you're an anime only, Hubert was one of the guys that the fake Yuha saw at episode 6 when he was fighting against Yamamoto, and he was like one of the resurrected Quincy's. So there you go. Big up Hubert. You remember the last time we see him, but big up Hubert. With that being said, great episode. I'm going to catch you motherfuckers out. You guys, of course, have this fun. Debian Hansen, and I'll see you next week for the last Bleach episodes for Core 2. Until we have a break. So, going to catch you motherfuckers out. You guys, of course, have this fun. Debian Hansen, as always, people. Peace out.